Hey everybody, I'm Em, and welcome to Em's 3 Adventures. This is a brand new Let's Play series I'm going to be doing, and my first game is going to be Fallout 3. And I'm going to be playing it in 3D. This is my first time going through the game, so I haven't really played any of the other Fallout games except for New Vegas, and so this is all brand new to me. Enjoy. I'm going to chime in occasionally. I'm not going to really talk much.
I don't want to set the world on fire. I just want to start a flame in your heart. In my heart I have but one desire, and that one is you. No other will do. I've lost all ambition for worldly acclaim. I just want to be the one you love. And with your admission that you feel the same, I'll have reached the goal I'm dreaming of. Be clean. I don't set the world.
That is one effed up city.
War never changes. Since the dawn of humankind, when our ancestors first discovered the killing power of rock and bone, blood has been spilled in the name of everything from God to justice to simple psychotic rage. In the year 2077, after millennia of armed conflict, the destructive nature of man could sustain itself no longer. The world was plunged into an abyss of nuclear fire and radiation. But it was not, as some had predicted, the end of the world. Instead, the apocalypse was simply the prologue to another bloody chapter of human history. For man had succeeded in destroying the world, but war never changes. In the early days, thousands were spared the horrors of the Holocaust by taking refuge in enormous underground shelters known as vaults. But when they emerged, they had only the hell of the wastes to greet them. All except those in Vault 101. For on that fateful day, when fire rained from the sky, the giant steel door of Vault 101 slid closed and never reopened. It was here you were born. It is here you will die. Because in Vault 101, no one ever enters, and no one ever leaves.
Hey, Let's see.
Ew, there's blood all over my face.
Or a girl?
Why are they asking the baby? The baby doesn't know shit.
It's a boy. A boy. We've got a son, Catherine. A beautiful, healthy baby boy.
Oh, James. We did it. A son. A beautiful son.
You've got a bright future ahead of you, son. I'm sure of it. Look at you. Look at you. Hi there. I'm your daddy, little guy. Daddy. You're going to need a name, aren't you? Your mother and I have been talking. What do you think about... That's a good name, don't you think? Fits you?
Yeah,
perfectly.
Sure.
Looks like they've finished the gene projection. Let's see what you'll look like when you're all grown up.
Yeah, it looks good. And there we go. I think I'll go shaved.
You're going to look a lot like your dad. See that, Catherine?
Or nothing like you at all.
Oh, very strapping.
It's a big world out there, son, full of all sorts of people. What about you? What kind of person are you going to be? You're
James?
Just a... Catherine?
James?
Catherine! She's in cardiac arrest. Start compressions. Get the baby out of here. Move! 1,000. 2,000. Come on. Hang on, Catherine. Hang on. Okay?
You one. We need a doctor, not a deadbeat.
This one's on the house.
Fail to meet my expectations and there will
don't
be
don't look straight into the light.
James and his cheery chatter.
Decorations.
May your future be bright for you, James.
This place will feel just like home. Come on over here, son. Come on. Walk to daddy. You can make it.
Mama.
Over here.
Cool.
You can make it. Come to daddy. Just a little further. You can make it. Over here. Come to Daddy. There you go. My goodness, just a year old and already walking like a pro. Your mother would have been so proud. Listen, kiddo, I know you don't like it when Daddy leaves you alone, but I need you to take care of yourself for a minute. You just stay here while Daddy runs to his office. You'll be okay, pal. I'll be back in a bit.
Worst father ever.
You are quite the little explorer, aren't you? Serves me right for trying to pin you in. Come on over here. I want to show you something. See that? It was your mother's favorite passage. It's from the Bible. Revelation 21:6. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. I will give unto him that is athirst of the fountain of the water of life freely. She always loved that. All right, come on. Let's go see if your little friend Amada wants to play.
Sure, whatever.
These experiments
don't
are
be a damn fool. The experiment to prepare. Prepare to survive. Of course I miss it.
Surprise!
Stanley, you turned the lights on too fast. You blinded the poor kid.
Happy birthday!
Happy birthday!
Can you believe it? He is growing up so fast.
Happy birthday, pal. I can't believe you're already 10. I'm so proud of you. If only your
Congratulations,
mother...
young man. I don't have to tell you how special this day is, do I? Down here in Vault 101,
the hell are you?
When you turn 10, well, you're ready to take on your first official Vault responsibilities. So
bullshit.
Here you are. As Overseer, I hereby present to you your very own Pip-Boy 3000. Get used to it. You'll be getting your first work assignment tomorrow.
Enjoy your party. You're only 10 once, so have fun.
Oh man, you got a Pip-Boy. I wish I was 10.
Happy birthday! We really surprised you, didn't we? Your dad was afraid you were onto us. But I told him not to worry. You're so easy to fool. a liar. Okay, if you're so smart, what did I get you for your birthday? Gross! I didn't think you even liked girls. And you know what I mean, before you say something rude about me. I guess maybe I should give this to someone else. Someone who likes Grognak the Barbarian better than mean Christine. The question is, how could you tell the difference?
Nice party. Happy birthday, Sonny.
Enjoying yourself? I hope you appreciate the effort Amara put into this party. I do not allow the fact that Amata is my daughter to compromise my position as overseer. I gave her... That is simply what my position requires. No more, no less. I know Amata understands that perfectly well.
Are you having a nice time? Are you having a nice party? 10 years old. My. Seems like only yesterday that your daddy came. Goodness, listen to me ramble. You're waiting for your present, aren't you? Fiddlesticks! What 10-year-old doesn't like presents? I was 10 once, believe it or not. My goodness, the vault was practically crowded back then. Not like today. So few young people now. But here I am rambling on again, and you listening so politely. Here you go, a nice sweet roll that I baked for you just this morning. And it's all for you. No sharing required today.
Attention, everyone. It's time to cut the cake.
Andy, wait!
Are you having a nice time?
Allow me to wish you a happy birthday. I told you not to act all official. I know you were joking, but I'm not sure anyone else did.
Nonsense. People always enjoy my little...
Hey, thanks for inviting me. Really cool party and everything. I know that, Butch and I give you a hard time, but you don't take that seriously, right? Anyway, happy birthday and everything. I better get back to, you know...
Beaches.
What, are you two
Besides,
best friends
that friend
now?
Of yours could use
hey,
a reminder
Paul,
that life is not
Paul's
all fun and games.
Yeah, Paul.
I'm hungry, and that stupid robot destroyed the cake. Give me that sweet roll you got from old Lady Palmer. Oh, yeah? We'll see about that.
I'm gonna be supposed to be a party, you know? Huh?
What do you mean, dork face here?
You should try it sometime, Dad.
Hey, Uncle!
Butch, what do you think you're doing? Leave him alone!
Nice party. Do you think you surprised him?
You all right,
sure
son?
Of it, Amata.
It didn't hurt
you. Expected a thing. Now go on.
This party's pretty good, I guess, for a little kid. Balloons, party hats. Not as cool as my party, though. Remember how my dad got Andy to do magic tricks, and we all played Hunt the Mutant in the atrium? Oh right, you weren't invited to my party. Too bad, man. It was really fun.
And enjoy yourself.
What's Butch's problem, anyway? I can't believe he tried to start a fight at your own birthday party. What a jerk. God, he really is a butthead. Oh well, you can always count on Butch to make an ass of himself. Get it?
Thanks
for coming, Stanley. I know you were busy with the water purifier.
What do you think about the cake?
Oh, sure, nothing to worry about. Me and Andy got her all fixed up again last night. Good as new.
Who wants to go around all day being called a
fix anything, right?
Sometimes I think you really are as dumb as you look. Come on, Wally. You always have good ideas.
How are you enjoying the party, Mrs. Palmer?
I got
Palmer?
One. The
I helped
Mackers.
With the decorations,
super
you know.
Cool, right?
Jeez,
oh,
Wally,
really?
Who's that of the
They're
gang?
Lovely.
You or me? No way.
You did such a splendid job.
How's it going, pal?
How do you like that Pip-Boy, son? Fit all right and everything? As a matter of fact, I did. I'm glad you like it. Some may think the A-Series a bit basic, but I've always preferred them for their reliability. Don't mention it. Oh, yes, I almost forgot. Happy birthday! Not much, but I hope you like it.
Oh. Are you all right? Is Butch giving you a hard time again? I wish we didn't have to invite him, but there just aren't that many children your age in the vault. In any case, you'll have to learn to deal with bullies. The world is full of people much worse than Butch, I'm afraid. But don't let him ruin your birthday. Go on. I bet there's someone else waiting to give you a present.
Hello, Officer Gomez. I'm glad you could make it.
I'm glad to be here. I think it's important.
Happy birthday!
Nice party.
Another youth well on his way to becoming a productive vault
citizen. You guys are dumb. Somebody's gotta have a better idea than those.
Here's one. Wally and the Big Cheese. That's you, Butch.
You're gonna be really sorry you missed... Nice
Thanks.
Try,
I'll send him right
be
down.
The Big Cheese and Wally?
How's it going, pal?
Why do you always have to get your name in there? You got...
Hey, that was Jonas on the intercom. He and I have been cooking up a little surprise present. Jonas is waiting for you downstairs on the reactor level. Go ahead. I don't think anyone will mind if you slip out for a few minutes.
You guys are dumb. Somebody's gotta have a better idea than
those. Are you having a nice time?
Are you having a nice time?
Paul, you
Enjoying
really
yourself?
Are as dumb as you look, aren't you? Sounds like a washing machine or something.
Fun party, huh?
Happy birthday, dearie. My goodness, I hope I didn't miss the party. They sure did. My, my. 10 years old already? Why, I can remember helping your dad change your diapers. And now look at you, a great big grown-up 10-year-old with your very own Pip-Boy. Since this was such a special occasion, do you know what I did? I wrote you a poem, just for you. I hope you like it. Of course. Run along now, dearie, and have yourself a wonderful birthday. Birthday.
Just be patient. You don't want to ruin the surprise, do you? Go ahead. Jonas is waiting.
I hope you're having a nice time.
Sure. I mean, I really like that one.
I wouldn't have missed it for the world.
Oh, never mind.
That
dear boy is like a son to me. Can't believe my mom made me come to this stupid party. Shows how smart you are, Wally. What should we call ourselves?
How about Hell's Overseers? Yeah, I like that.
Did you know
at least it doesn't
the average life
these.
Expectancy
Enjoy the
of a resident in a properly maintained vault
I only showed
is
up because of Mata's
92.3 years.
Give them a few more minutes, and then I want that place cleaned up and everybody back to work.
What are you doing down here, young man? I thought kids weren't allowed down on the reactor level. Hey, relax. I was just teasing. Listen, now that you're 10, you don't have to take guff like that from grown-ups anymore. Got it? Hold on one more minute. I think your dad will want to give you the surprise himself.
Are you ready for your surprise? The Overseer gave you your Pip-Boy, and you're old enough to do some work, so I figure you're old enough for this. Your own BB gun. It's a little old, but it should work perfectly. Jonas found it down here. It was in pretty rough shape. Took us a good 3 months to find the parts to get it working again. You know how tough it is to find a spring that small? Good thing Butch misplaced that switchblade of his. So, what do you think? Want to give it a try? We sure can't, unless we want the Overseer beating down our door. Jonas and I have found a place, though. Come on.
Happy birthday, buddy. I hope you have fun with it. Hey, you don't turn 10 every day. Now go on and let me see you shoot something.
Well, what do you think? You can come down here and shoot anytime you want. Couldn't have done it without Jonas's help. You make sure to thank him.
Go on, shoot something for me.
You can do this. Careful, it's a rad roach. Think you can take care of that with your BB gun? Just aim and shoot. You'll be fine. Good work. That's one less rat roach to deal with. Let's get a picture together. Capture the moment. Hey, Jonas, get a picture of me with a big game hunter. Over here, son.
Smile!
Boys and girls have different parts.
What is her problem anyway? So, I'm the Overseer's daughter, so what? Like, I get any kind of special treatment.
Revelation 21:6. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end.
As far as I can tell, you're a perfectly healthy 16-year-old boy. So yes, you have to go to class to take your goat exam. Go on now. You've got a goat to take. The Generalized Occupational Aptitude Test. Goat. Everyone here in the vault takes it when they're 16. Helps to figure out what sort of a job you'll have here in Vault 101 when you get a bit older. So, pay attention and try not to fall asleep. You know what the Overseer says? We're born in the vault, we die in the vault. Each is tested to determine their abilities, that they may work for the betterment of all Vault residents. Huh. Sound familiar? That's not the way it works. And it won't do to go around asking questions like that. Especially not around the Overseer. I want to tell you something now. It's important, so listen closely. This place, this vault, it's not perfect, I know. But it is your home. You're safe here. Stay on the Overseer's good side, and you always will be. You understand? You need to appreciate all you have. Because what's up there, on the outside, that's not the life I want for you. And it's not what your mother wanted for you either. That's what the Overseer says, isn't it? He's not about to let anyone else in, so I guess that's how it'll have to be. You're here now, and it's a hell of a lot better than being up there. All your mother and I ever wanted was for you to be safe, and you're safe here. Your mother, she was beautiful. But beyond the beauty you've seen. There's just so much those old photos can never show. And she was passionate. About life, about love. But most of all she was passionate about you. When she became pregnant, it was the happiest I had ever seen her. Ah, she had great things in mind for you. And so, time for you to stop stalling and get to class. Please, son, please, take these achievement tests seriously. The last thing I need is your mother's ghost haunting me because her only child became a garbage burner. Hey, it's not my call. Those are the rules. You're 16 now, so this year you take the goat. Come on, it's not so bad. Everyone has to take it. You'll do just fine. No, you are not. Really. When I started studying medicine, one of the first things I learned was how to spot a kid playing sick to get out of taking a test. You'll do fine. It's not so bad. Everyone has to take it when they're 16. I had to, and most everyone makes it through. Take care, son. Now get out of here, and good luck. Morning, Jonas.
Morning.
Have you had a chance to look over these results?
Good. I was just going over them. Something you're worried about?
I'd just like to keep an eye on it.
No problem. I'll have my report ready. This afternoon.
Sounds good. Let me know if there are any changes.
Good morning. Stopped in to see the old man before class, eh? Hi, Stanley. Sorry to keep you waiting. What seems to be the trouble today?
I've got this headache that just won't go away. Even with the pills you gave me last week? It's the lights, I think. They hurt my eyes.
That's still bothering you. Well, I can run a few more tests if you like.
Yes, I think I'd like that. Will it take long?
Oh, shouldn't be too long. I just need to get things set up for you. Just sit tight and I'll be with you as soon as I can.
You better stay away. I don't want you to catch what I've got.
Get out of my way, you stupid tunnel snakes!
I can show you a real tunnel snake, Amaya.
God, Butch! Why don't you just leave me alone?
She's not too Butch.
What is it now, sir?
Daddy's girl, daddy's girl.
You think you're special because your daddy is the overseer? Tell her, Butch!
Get away from me!
What's the matter? Daddy's girl gonna cry?
Show it to her, Butch.
She's nothing, Butch.
Don't mess with the tunnel snakes. What? You mouthing off, Spaz? Everyone knows the tunnel snakes. We rule this vault, and we don't take shit from nobody. Not you, not her, and not her daddy, the overseer. Stay out of this. It's tunnel snake business. Me and Butch were just having some fun with this chick. I don't follow anyone. Wally Mack is his own man, and the tunnel snakes is where I belong. Why? You think Butch is in charge? Is that what people are saying? Because it's a load of shit if that's what they're saying. What? What kind of shit is that? No one talks that way about Wally Mack. He's not the boss of me. Nobody's the boss of me. I'm out of here.
She's nothing,
Butch. We're done
Butch.
Here.
Done? We're not done. I say... Tunnel snakes rule. That's us, and we rule. No one messes with the tunnel snakes, or they have to answer to... None of your business, because Butch said so. Tunnel snakes rule. Because he's my pal, my brother. Mostly because tunnel snakes rule! You got that? Better. Can't think of anything. Butch says this little bitch is blabbing to her daddy about us. Because we're the tunnel snakes. Can't. Because. Much later. Tunnel snakes rule! When we're done.
Don't know who put you in charge. I say we're done. Let's go, Paul.
Are you sure? Butch? Okay. Whatever you say, Wally. Tunnel snakes rule. Fine, let's go. I was done here anyway. This ain't over, Daddy's...
Hey,
I'm not
Susie,
finished with you either, twerp.
Oh, not much. Oh, God, that's over.
Our heater's on the fritz again.
You're kidding.
This isn't over, Punk.
Didn't you just get new parts for
this
it last
over,
week?
Punk.
This isn't
yeah,
over, Punk.
Sure did.
This isn't over, so...
Thanks for getting rid of them. Assholes. I don't know why they won't leave me alone. Just because my father's the overseer, I guess? Idiots.
Old, my grandpa had trouble with it when he was my age.
This isn't
well,
over.
I hope it's working again soon for you.
Thanks. Say, you want to grab some lunch later on?
Sure thing. How about we head down to the diner at...
Well, you made it. All set for the goat? Trust me, it really isn't that bad. Just something everybody has to go through. I'm sure you will, especially since it's multiple choice with no wrong answers. We'll start as soon as everyone's found a seat. Good luck. Let's not keep the overseer waiting.
Not a good idea. Get out of my face. You nervous? I'm not. This isn't over, punk.
Go ahead, take a seat so we can start.
Hey there. Oh, hi. Why are you talking to me?
I hope you weren't just talking to me.
Thanks for getting rid of them. Assholes.
What? What do you want, nerd?
Let's not keep the overseer waiting.
Get out of my face.
Go ahead, take a seat so we can start. Well, now that everyone has managed to find the classroom, we can finally get started. No talking, and keep your eyes to yourselves. Yes, I'm talking to you, Mr. Deloria.
Sure thing, Mr. Brotch.
Unless anyone else has an insightful comment, let's get started. Question one. A frenzied vault scientist runs up to you and yells, I'm going to put my quantum harmonizer in your photonic resonation chamber. What's your response? Question two. While working as an intern in the clinic, a patient with a strange infection in his foot stumbles through the door. The infection is spreading at an alarming rate, but the doctor stepped out for a while. What do you do? Question three. You discover a young boy lost in the lower levels of the vault. He's hungry and frightened, but also appears to be in possession of stolen property. What do you do? Question 4. Congratulations. You've made one of the Vault 101 baseball teams. Which position do you prefer? Question 5. Your grandmother invites you to tea, but you're surprised when she gives you a pistol and orders you to kill another vault resident. What do you do? Question 6. Old Mr. Abernathy has locked himself in his quarters again, and you've been ordered to get him out. How do you proceed? Question 7. Oh no! You've been exposed to radiation, and a mutated hand has grown out of your stomach. What's the best course of treatment? Question 8. A fellow Vault 101 resident is in possession of a Grognak the Barbarian comic book, issue number 1. You want it. What's the best way to obtain it? Question 9. You decide it would be fun to play a prank on your father. You enter his private restroom when no one is looking and... Question 10. Who is indisputably the most important person in Vault 101? He who shelters us from the harshness of the atomic wasteland, and to whom we owe everything we have, including our lives. Pencils down, people. That's it. The infamous goat. I'm sure most of you didn't find it so bad. Others, well, there are always openings in the maintenance department. Don't forget to hand in your test before you leave. You don't want to know what happens to people who fail the goat. You can have the rest of the day off to celebrate or to pray, as the situation warrants.
Stop bothering me. I've just got to figure out this last one. This isn't over, punk.
Thank God that's over. Come on, let's go get some lunch.
All finished?
Here you are, Mr. Brotch. I hope I did okay.
Nothing for you to worry about, Miss Almodovar. Let's see. Very well done. Looks like it's the supervisory track for you.
Thanks. See you tomorrow.
I've got other things to do.
Well, well. Pip-Boy programmer, eh? Stanley will finally have someone to talk shop with. Yes, it's refreshing to see such, youthful enthusiasm. Good to know that the goat occasionally gets it right. You know what they say about monkeys and typewriters. Well, I'm glad things turned out so well for you. I hope your classmates find their results half as satisfying.
Yo, Teach, I'm done.
Ah, Butch. Can I admit that I've been waiting for this day for a long, long...
Bye.
You did fine. You should celebrate with your friends.
This isn't over, punk.
Yes? Friends? Oh, we're never going to be friends.
Why are you talking to me?
You again. What did I tell you about talking to me, huh?
I can't figure out number five. What is it, Feed?
First, I think I should listen to my grandmother. But then, isn't killing someone wrong?
Mother can't wait to find out if I'll be going to science or...
I'll see you tomorrow, right now.
Anything is possible, even an A.
Daddy's
Mr.
not right here to save you now. Is he?
Selfish and insubordinate.
Wake up!
You
come
need
on,
to
wake
know
up!
These things. I'm not going to be around to hold your hand forever.
Come on! You've got to wake up! You've got to get out of here! Your dad is gone, and my father's men are looking for you! He's left the vault! I don't know how, but he's gone, and my father, he's kind of gone crazy. It's Jonas! They killed him! My father's men! They took him and... Oh my God, you have to leave now! Yeah, it's lucky I got here ahead of them. But we can't stand here talking. You've got to get out of here. Oh, so you don't trust me now? Thanks a lot. You think it was easy for me to get here, with the rad roaches and security all over the place? Your sense of self-preservation never fails to rise to the surface. Lucky for you, I have a plan. I can help you follow your dad and escape from the vault. Listen, there's a secret tunnel that leads directly from my father's office to the exit. You'll have to hack the computer in his office to open it. Use these to get into his office. That's how I always get in. My father's not stupid. He's sealed the door to the exit to prevent anyone else from escaping. The tunnel is the only way out! You're just gonna have to trust me! Oh, one more thing. I stole my father's pistol. I hope you won't need it, but you'd better take it just in case. Okay, I'll try to meet you at the exit. Watch out for security. Good luck! I'll meet you at the vault door if I can, but don't wait for me.
There he is. Hold it right there.
Crime and more roaches.
What's the matter, huh? Can't stand the sight of your own blood?
Get it off me!
Gotta help me! My mom's trapped in there with the rat roaches! Yeah, I'm... Look, I'm sorry for the way I... But it's my mom. Sure, I don't care why. Just get her out of there. Okay, you're the best friend I've ever had, man. Hey, I know it isn't much, but I want you to have my Tunnel Snake's jacket. Go ahead, take it.
Where do those things come from? Oh, I need another drink. Where did those things come from?
You're the best, man. The best. Everything's gonna be okay now, thanks to you.
This is the Overseer. All residents of Vault 101 are hereby confined to their quarters. The rat roach infestation is under control. Do not interfere with Vault security personnel. of Vault 101 are hereby confined to their quarters. The rat roach infestation is under control. Do not interfere with Vault security personnel. Any resident found outside his or her quarters will be dealt with severely.
Excitement for one day. Ah, young sir, how very good to see you.
You're the one everybody's looking for, right? Well, it's none of my business. Your dad always took good care of us.
I believe he's gone topside.
All residents of Vault 101 are hereby confined to their quarters. The rat roach infestation is under control. Do not interfere with Vault security personnel. Any resident found outside his or her quarters will be dealt with severely. That is all.
Hold still. Your left stabilizer's been knocked loose.
I am holding still. It's your old pulsing hands that are shaking.
If you keep turning like that, I'm gonna crack your casing.
Don't blame me for your incompetence. Why, I remember...
This vault's been going to... Me and Andy were in a tight spot there. Ain't no mistake. Good thing he loves toasting roaches so much. Cut it out. And you'll be as good as new.
I might think you just made it worse. Should I do this myself?
I think I found the problem.
I don't believe you. I expect we'll be here for hours.
Almost got it.
Oh, I think I'd rather just stay broken than submit to any further indignity.
I think I found the problem.
I think you just made it worse. Should I do this myself?
This vault's been going to pot ever since that young elf. I'm not sure how I could help. I've almost got it.
Do you have any idea what you're doing back there?
Don't be such an old woman. Just a few more adjustments and you'll be as good as new.
Any idea what you're doing back there?
It's our only chance, don't you see? We're getting out of here, just like the doctor. I'm not gonna let anyone stop us. It's me!
Tom! Be careful!
Come out, gymnastics.
Rolls!
We would find you eventually. No!
You! This is your fault. You and your stupid father. He had to go and leave, didn't he? He had to mess things up for everybody. The kid's over here. He's trying to leave the ball. Don't let him get away.
They're everywhere.
You. I don't know anything.
Be reasonable, Amata. Officer Mac may enjoy this, but I don't. Just tell us where to find your friend so we can talk to him.
He's my friend. I was worried about him.
Hold it right there. Your father betrayed us all. Damn.
Oh!
There's more where that came from.
Stop with the name of the overseer. There he is! Guard, help me!
God, what have you done? You killed him! Why would you kill my father?
Hold on, Jonas. I need to record this first. I don't really know how to tell you this. I hope you'll understand, but I know you might be angry. I thought about it for a long time, but in the end, I decided it was best for you not to know. So many things could have gone wrong, and there's really no telling how the Overseer will react when he finds out. It's best if he can blame everything on me. Obviously, you already know that I'm gone. It was something I needed to do. You're an adult now. You're ready to be on your own. Maybe someday things will change and we can see each other again. I can't tell you why I left or where I'm going. I don't want you to follow me. God knows life in the vault isn't perfect, but at least you'll be safe. Just knowing that will be enough to keep me going.
Don't mean to rush you, Doc, but I'd feel better if we got this over with.
Okay, go ahead. Goodbye. I love you.
weakened it.
Good, you're leaving. I guess you were trying to help me, but you didn't have to kill him! So you say. Maybe one day I'll be able to forgive you. But not now. I hope you never have to find out what it's like to see your father killed right in front of you. No! Don't listen to me. Just go! Find your father! I have to go bury mine! No, I can't. Not with you, not now. You'd better leave before I change my mind about letting you go.
I knew you'd turn up sooner or later.
I already said everything.
Yeah! Oh! 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 Yeah!
Please, just go. I already said everything I had to say.
Thank you.
That is all.